What a voice. That was the new single, I Know Where I've Been, from singer Marisha Wallace. She's a woman of many talents. Not only is she a Broadway and West End superstar, recording artist and TikTok vocal coach, she's also worked for Philip Seymour Hoffman back in the day. Would you believe that?
We're really getting to know her morning. Last year, she landed a major record deal after a track she recorded during lockdown went viral. Now, she's a leading lady in the West End musical Hairspray this summer alongside legendary Michael Ball.
Marisha Wallace joins us on the line from London. But first, let's take a look at her vocal talents on the West End stage.
Oh, oh, you can't stop today. No. As it comes speeding down the tracks. How yesterday is history.
Oh, I don't think I've ever missed a theatre more in my life. Good morning, Marisha. How are you?
Hi, Marisha.
Good morning. I'm great.
I hope you have that number as your ringtone on your phone. Please say you do. What a song.
Oh, I don't even have to. It's on repeat in my head all day long.
I hear you. As we said in the intro, we're both complimenting your voice. It's such a great voice, but you've got so many strings to your bow. Let's go back to where it started, though, for you, Marisha, if we could, because you're from North Carolina. You'd never seen or been to a Broadway show. But how did it end up on your radar? How did, you know, I know you were surrounded by music growing up as a kid, but how did that become the focus in your life?
Well, I grew up on a pig farm in North Carolina. And I, you know, like Charlotte's Web, where they had like the little pig and they would take care of it and then it would go to the hog farm. That was what I did when I was little. But my family was very musical. My mom and my dad and my grandma, everybody sings and plays instruments. So that's what we did. And so, like, I grew up singing. My grandma was like a Mahalia Jackson of our town. So we would go around singing at all the churches. And then I had this amazing music teacher in high school who was like, wait a minute, I don't think you're like the other kids. I think you need to like try to think about doing this professionally. And so she took her own time and took and drove me for hours to different auditions at universities to try to get into the music programs. And at the time I was trying to just go into just vocal performance. And you had to do opera. And I had never sang opera in my life. I was a gospel singer. So I had to learn to sing in Italian. I could barely speak English, and I had to learn to sing in Italian. And so I, you know, auditioned for the music school, and I actually didn't get in, which was so crazy. I found out that I had a cyst on my vocal cord at 17 years old, had to get a vocal surgery, told me I was never going to possibly ever sing again. And thanks to God, prayer, and I got the surgery. And 3 months later, I was working with a new vocal coach and I got my voice back. And they were like, hey, do you want to do musical theater? And then that's how I fell into musical theater. And from there, I, you know, went to university, got into the program, auditioned again and got in. And then from there, you know, Broadway came and then the West End came. And it's just been an amazing journey. Going from a no to the right yes has been incredible.
But you have to go through all of those auditions and castings and knockbacks to be able to cope with the world of Broadway and the West End. And the curtain has lifted on theatre in the UK. We're not there yet. We're very excited about it coming down the tracks. But you are not in rehearsals. You are in the thick of Hairspray in the West End in London at the moment, Marisha.
We are on stage with full capacity audiences, 2,400 people. We had sold out shows over the past week. It's been incredible. I have never seen a response like this in my life. People are standing, crying. After I Know Where I've Been, my song, they're screaming, standing up, mid-show standing ovation. People are hungry for theater, and it's so exciting.
It's an amazing show. I mean, that number in particular, it just gets the audience out of their seats. You know, when you realised that dream and you got to Broadway for the first time with Book of Mormon, talk us through that period in your life, because to get there and go through the struggles and go through vocal surgery, go through training, get knocked back, to stand on stage on Broadway in probably the biggest hit that Broadway had seen in 25 years, what was that like?
It was incredible because, you know, I come from a small town. I didn't grow up with a lot of money or anything like that. It's literally been just sheer hard work and determination. And then when your dreams actually start to come true, they actually scare you because you're like on stage and you're like, what is happening? Oh, I actually did it. But I just feel so proud because if I can do it, then I know that there's somebody else out there who can do it. And that's what was really amazing about it. But it's just been an incredible journey. And I never thought I would be on the West End. This was not even in my radar at all. I was working on Broadway, and then Amber Riley got sick during Dreamgirls, and they called me over and said, learn the show in 5 days. And then I was leading a show on the West End, and that's how I got here. And then I just took that torch and ran with it, and I'm still here.
But it's not just the voice, Marisha. It's the charisma. It's your personality. It's the sparkle. You have it all. The music is a huge part of your life, obviously, and there's an album there. Tell us about that.
Well, I have a new EP out called Soul of the Stage right now. It's a compliment to my first album that just came out called Tomorrow. Soul of the Stage is full of musical theater songs. It's my love letter to my fans who have followed me from being a tap dancing egg on Broadway to being a leading lady. I Know Where I've Been is on the EP, and so you can take that home. So, you know, everyone has been loving the song, so now you can take it home, listen to it in your car, show all your friends. It's got Memory on it, a beautiful soul version of that, Heart of Stone from Six, and then also Miles and Miles from Jingle Jangle, the Christmas musical I did for Netflix.
Amazing. And like most other actors, Marisha, you've held a variety of jobs in your career, you know, to supplement your career, and none more so than when you're in New York. You got the gig on Book of Mormon, but it wasn't starting, of course, for 6 or 7 months. So you thought, I need to get some money. So what did you do?
Well, I was a nanny for like just celebrity families. And one of my clients was Philip Seymour Hoffman.
Wow.
And so I go to this beautiful loft apartment down in the lower part of Manhattan. And I walk in and it's literally, I was like, I didn't even know apartments existed like this in New York. I was like, what is this? And his son literally is a spitting image of him.
Wow.
And I only worked with the mom, so I didn't get to meet him right away. And so as I put the kids to bed, and then I was walking out, and they have their own private elevator, as you do when you're a celebrity. And the elevator goes ding. I'm like walking out, and there he is. He was standing there. He was like, hi, Marisha.
My goodness.
And I was like, hi. And he was like, how were the kids? And I was like, they were amazing. And then he gave me a $50 tip.
Fantastic. Listen, Marisha, we could talk to you all day. You're already a favourite guest of ours on the show. Please come back and talk to us again. Best of luck with the show in London and everything that you do. You are a star.
Take care, Marisha.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.
Right, don't forget, Marisha's EP, Soul of the Stage, is now available to stream.
She's made instant friend of the show status, hasn't she?
Love her.
Fast-tracked.
Love her.